What are we going to do as a church? Our souls need to wake up. We need to respond to the gospel of Jesus. He said, go into the world.
We don't want to deal with reality, Christian. We don't even want to deal with reality, even though we've been saved from this place.
I'm calling on you today in the name of Jesus to rise up to the call of God. Christ is coming back soon.
If I start telling people about hell, I might just scare them off. Where are you going to scare them off to? Hell number two? People stop thinking about it. If hell really exists, and it does, I didn't say that Jesus did, then don't you think people need to know about it? Can't you at least give them a fighting chance? Or are you just going to sit there and let them burn?
This is Chris from Don't Let Them Burn. Welcome to our show. I got my partner Rory right here.
Hey, everybody. This is Rory from Don't Let Them Burn. Good evening. How's everybody doing?
Okay, so this show is just to give you a few updates. We're going to be bringing on some special guests. As you know, we always bring on some special guests, but the guests that are coming in a few weeks are going to really inundate you with some information because of some things that are supposedly prophesied in the later part of the year. So we want you to stick around and share the information and also subscribe if you're a new listener. And remember that you can always find us on our website, don'tletthemburn.com. And you can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, and a whole host of social media platforms, including Minds.com. So, you know, there's a lot of things going on in the world. And, you know, we've done some movie reviews and we're going to be doing a couple more. And it's interesting, the reaction to the Wonder Woman review. That was very interesting. But there's so much going on in the world, and of course, we're not news broadcasters. We try to bring in what we find and try to put a whole story around it and basically lead you back to the Word of God. Rory?
Yes, a lot of things that are going on that we need to share, update people, sharing God's wonderful Word with everyone, and just letting them know that, listen, the time is at hand. The kingdom of God is at hand. And you know what? We are going to share with you some very pertinent information that you can share with others and helping to redeem their, well, we don't help necessarily, but being directed by the Holy Spirit that leads us into all truth and set the captives free. So please keep it in mind. Check us out. Make sure that you subscribe. And also, if you have any questions, comments, we'd be glad to answer. Thank you so much.
And so, in the world that we have today, there's a lot of movement in tech and genetics, biogenetics, and stuff like that. So, what we're going to do, we're going to be formulating a show for you guys that's going to be dealing with the book of Daniel. And we might go into the book of Revelation too, but we're going to construct something that might surprise a lot of you. Some of you might not, but it's something that we're starting to see unfold in front of our eyes. And within the next 10 years, you're going to see that this world is going to be much, much different than it looks today. And I'm not saying that because of a thought that just came to my head. This is the evidence that's out there. We're going to be unleashing some of that on you guys. And also, there's an uptick in supernatural activity around the planet. We're talking about demon possessions, apparitions, so-called alien, you know, sightings and things like that. So we're going to be bringing our show called The Alien Deception in Movies. We're going to edit it and basically present it to you the way that it was when we first aired it. But it's going to be a lot of video in it too. Also, we're going to be working on a couple documentaries, and we need your help. We don't usually ask for money at all. But if you want to, you can find us on Patreon and Fundly and donate whatever you can, because we need equipment to do these documentaries around these subject matters that many people aren't really touching. And what we try to do is give you an outlook from the social aspect to biblical aspect to what's going on in our culture. And right now we're fighting a major culture war. Rory?
Yes. You know, as we expose these things, we are seeing that a lot of things are on the uptick. A lot of things that are, you're talking about possession, it's out there even more. And we are seeing a lot more of these things in the movies today. Even on the internet, it's becoming popular. It looks intriguing to a lot. And people are getting sucked in on a regular basis. And this is why we are here. This is the reason why we're here, is to share God's word with everyone so that they'll be able to see what's going on and pull them away from the fire in the name of Jesus Christ.
That's right. And that's a name we uphold beyond any other name, Jesus Christ. He is Lord. And I know people have, you know, a lot of different ideas about the name, what name to say, but, you know, demons flee in the name of Jesus Christ. When there are manifestations in your house, I bet you, I don't even have to bet you, just call on the name of Jesus and you see what happens. If it's some sort of spiritual presence holding you down, call on the name of Jesus if you can, if they allow you to speak, and watch what happens. The name of Jesus holds power. And there's a reason for that, because he is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. You know, some people say you can't use the word Lord, but I say it again. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So even if Baal was called a Lord or any other entity, he is the Lord of Lords.
He said in his word that he's the Alpha and the Omega. He's the start and the finish. He sits on the edge of time. That's my God. That's the God that you're talking about. There's none that's like him.
That's right. You know, that's
unique.
Right.
He's unique.
That's right. And, you know, I have a ton of books here to read. So you're going to see information come out that, you know, probably you haven't heard us talk about before. But one of the biggest things that I see is that people have a real interest in all of these superheroes and replacement gods, but there's not enough education out about them. Well, you know, I'm not going to say the education isn't out there, but a lot of people don't realize how many books have been written, not necessarily to expose the character of the gods and what gods they go back to, but people are just writing books letting you know that a lot of these superheroes, many, many, many of them, almost all, go back to some sort of pagan idea. And this, we're in this age now where it's not going away, just like zombies. Zombies are not going away anytime soon, because cannibalism is the thing. It's a new entertainment right next to superheroes. Right, Rory?
Oh, yeah. Just like in the article that we read earlier, where the CNN reporter went on screen and was eating a human brain. And you see, they're saying to people now, it's not bad. You know, the Bible talks about woe unto those who call good evil and evil good. And for the first time in history, this is what we're seeing today. So when we come back, we're going to talk about a lot of these strange things that are happening. And you're going to see what the Word of God says about these things.
Yeah, speaking of strange things that are happening, we have a show called that. And you want to go there and check out what we're talking about in that show. And you also want to check out our shows on technology. You want to check out our show called Destroying the Image of God. It's a long series, but if you're young or old, doesn't matter. It will give you some insights on why our culture is the way it is and what man, the heart of man, the wickedness in the heart of man has done to propel us towards hell, perdition, you know? There's a movie called Road to Perdition, and it's about a gangster that's on the wrong end of things, and, you know, the gangs are after him. But the real road to perdition is the consequence of sin. It's death, you know, and hell. And thank God that he saved us from the consequence of sin. I don't have to worry about death. I don't have to worry about hell. Many of you out there are searching for eternal life, when Jesus Christ has already brought it. It's already finished, you know? And this work of salvation that Christ did on the cross, that is the only way for you to get eternal life. Many of you are going to gamble out there and say, well, you know, I could be a Buddhist or a Shinto or whatever. All roads lead to God. But that's just what it is. It's a gamble. We have assurance in the person of Jesus Christ. Our faith gets shaken sometimes because of circumstances, but yet the Holy Spirit will bring us back to that assurance. And that's why we walk the way we walk, and we talk the way we talk, and why we are a peculiar people, and why we are a unique species. We are the only species, once we're born again with the Holy Spirit in us, that are like us. Anyone outside of that are not the same. And that's magnificent. That just blows my mind. Go ahead, Rory.
There are so many things to talk about, Chris, and we're seeing that people are into a smorgasbord of different faith or different religion. And, you know, the Lord said in his word that he's going to turn them over to a reprobate mind. And it's just sad and unfortunate that we see in today's world that things are just rapidly moving ahead. You know, I think you talked earlier about transhumanism. We're looking at that. We're looking at all the different things, the sexual things that are coming at kids today. It's amazing to see the load of garbage that's coming at them, that a child can't be who he or she needs to be. But now people are being treated as neutral. Or in Canada, if a child comes home at age 9 and they say, well, or whatever age it is, young age, they say, well, I think I need to be the opposite sex, the government has the right to come in and take the child. You know, right. It's unfortunate. Then you have the Kinsey's file, or the Kinsey, some of the things that he wrote dealing with sexuality and children, and these are what we're dealing with in our society today. And it's so unfortunate that people are being duped on a daily basis and they don't know it.
Oh yeah, that's for sure.
You know,
yeah. And that's a whole nother show in itself altogether, and we will be doing a show on all of that. And just bringing you some real pertinent information that I can almost guarantee that you don't know, you know, because it's really hard to gather everything in one place. And I have the time to actually shift through a lot of the information, watch different videos from different commentators or different articles to say, hey, look at this over here, and look at this over there. Look at this in the movie. Look at this in the songs. What's going on here? It's a spiritual movement that has been propelled by spiritual forces, of course, powers and principalities and spiritual wickedness in high places. We are in a spiritual war, not just for our souls, but for the souls of our families. Our kids are the main target. Never forget that. Your kids, our kids, are the main target, because what one generation doesn't accept, the next one will. And that has been proven time and time again, especially here in the Western world. So, parents, be on guard. The tech, the entertainment, the schooling, the friends. Be careful of the friends that your children keep. I mean, that's always been a standard, right? But nowadays, kids are sharing pornography, you know? Oh, so you don't want your child to play Call of Duty or some other violent video game? Oh, well, when they go over to their friend's house, guess what they're playing? So, you know, it's not to shelter kids from the world, but it's to protect them from the grip of sin. And how do we do that? Through the Word of God, through living a godly life, and teaching them what the Word of God says about the Almighty Creator, Jesus Christ. Rory?
Yes. I think that a lot of kids need to get into the Word of God so they could learn what the Word of God says. And, you know, I was listening to a video earlier this week where the gentleman actually said, you know, to do away with all the boundaries that God had set in place, to get rid of them. And it's not coming from a Christian. This is what they want. This is what they're going after. And you know what I say to people? time for us to get in the Word. It's time for us to go and seek God for yourself. Don't listen to anybody else. Go and seek God for yourself. And I just pray that, you know, you will tune in for the upcoming shows, and we'll have a great time. I thank you all for listening, and it was fun.
Yeah. Don't forget to like and share our videos, even this one, even though it's a brief update. I think we said a lot, and it's very important that parents protect your family. Serve God. And there's only one God. Don't get it confused. Whether you want to call him Yahweh, Yeshua, Jesus, it's only one God. Okay? So, that's it for tonight. And don't forget to check us out at don'tletthemburn.com. Of course, you want to check this out on YouTube. And share, like, share, subscribe. Thank you. That's our show for tonight.
Thank you. Have a good night.
If you like our videos, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell to get all our frequent updates.